Division X. The Capitals taking over first place with an incredible 11 wins in their last 12 games. The badly injured Flyers have lost in a row and look to the return of Tim Kirk, their lineup. It's a battle for first place, and you'll see it live from the Spectrum right here on your superstation for sports, DC20.
DC20, your station for sports, proudly presents... DC20, your superstation for sports, proudly presents Washington Capitals Hockey. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Budweiser, the king of beers. By Giant Food, we care about quality and value, we care about you. By Amtrak, take Amtrak to any one of over 500 destinations nationwide. By Circuit City, and by Dashes, with the largest selection of traditional and designer men's clothing.
Tonight, live from the Spectrum in Philadelphia, it's the Washington Capitals and the Philadelphia Flyers here on DC20. Good evening, everybody. Mike Forns, your play-by-play host, along with Al Koken. The Capitals in first place in the Patrick Division, and they take on the Flyers, against whom they've been very successful this season. Al, the Flyers are badly shaken up with a lot of injuries in their lineup tonight, costing them some players that normally play a big role in their game. But they've got Tim Kerr coming back, and they're looking to him for a boost.
Well, people in Washington may have read in their morning paper that Tim Kerr definitely would not be in the lineup tonight. Do not blame Bob Fache and Dave Fay for that misinformation. Blame Tim Kerr. He said it on Tuesday, but he's decided to play tonight. We go downstairs to Capitals coach Brian Murray. And, Brian, does this add a little pressure to your team?
Well, certainly the fans will respond to a Tim Kerr coming back. And I believed all along that he would play. I indicated that earlier to our players. And he certainly, in this building, will be a tremendous asset at the beginning of the game in particular.
Brian, what kind of a role do you expect Kerr to play on the ice? Can you expect him to be 100% coming back into this game? He's been so devastating against your club in the past.
Well, I would hope he would be, and I can't believe that he would be able to play the 60 minutes on a regular basis. But he will be a tremendous factor, I would think, on their power play and the first 30 or so seconds of a shift, where if I can read Mike Keenan at all, I would imagine an offensive face-offs, Tim Kerr will be on the ice. On a lot of situations involving a jam at the net, he will be on the ice, and then they will take him off in defensive situations.
Brian, the Flyers still are missing some key players, Rick Tocchet, Dave Poole, and Ron Sutter. Do you expect them to try and do anything differently? The games between the two teams so far this year have been, I thought, surprisingly peaceful. Do you expect maybe a little more physical contest tonight as the Flyers try and make up for some of the loss of manpower?
Well, the key that they have, they've got Mark Howe back, and they got young Kerry Hoffman back, and so their defensive core as a group is intact. They got Ron Hextall playing goal, so they've got to believe that defensively they can do a pretty good job. Where they've got to count on some help is scoring goals, and I'm not sure where they'll come from totally, but they do have some people like Propp, like Kerr, like Zazzle, that make up a pretty good line and have a chance to score. So I can't think that they'll be too disruptive, although Berube and Hill are in the lineup, and I'm sure they're in the lineup for that reason.
Brian, your club has been so successful over the last 11 games, and certainly to carry it on through a contest here in this building where you've already had some success this year would give you another great boost.
Well, it really would, I think, especially within the division. Obviously, we'd like to finish first, but that's not the end-all. We want to make sure our team is healthy and well going into the playoffs. However, when you play the Philadelphia Flyers and you play in this building, it's a contest of great extent for us in that we have a chance to prove something. I think we've been criticized in the past years for not doing so well in here. So we've won a couple of times. I'd like to win another hockey game in here and you know, leave with a pretty good taste in our mouth.
All right, Brian. Well, good luck tonight. Thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
Capitals coach Brian Murray, as the Washington Capitals and Philadelphia Flyers are about to square off to settle first place for tonight in the Patrick Division. Al and I will be back with the starting lineups and also the first face-off of this game after we pause for these messages here on DC20.
Oh, say,
Darla Mohawk with our national anthem. Refereeing tonight's game between the Capitals and the Flyers, Kerry Fraser, working with Bob Hodges and Ron Finn. Starting in goal for Washington, it's Clint Mularchuk. In 23 victories, 17 losses, and 3 ties on the year for Clint, with 47 games played, 128 goals against, and a 2.98 average, 4 shutouts. Pete Peters will back him up. Ron Hextall goes for the Flyers, 28-17-5 on the year. Tonight is his 54th appearance of the year. He's allowed 173 goals against and a 3.42 average, no shutouts. He's backed up by Mark LaForest. Well, the Flyers wasting a little time in getting Tim Kerr into the action. He's starting out on right wing. Peter Zezel is at center, Prop on the left wing side, with Mark Howe back on defense for Philadelphia, as well as Shel Samuelson. The Capitals have Mike Ridley, with Kelly Miller and Mike Gartner, Scott Stevens and Larry Murphy. Fraser's all set to go at center ice. The puck is dropped in. Washington gets the draw. We're underway. Here's Scott Stevens throwing it back inside the Flyers' zone. Mike Gartner on the right wing turns it around for Ridley, but he shoots it wide of the net. Now Kerr starts out ahead to Prop at center ice. Dumps it in on goal. Mularchuk makes the save and covers up. And right away, Kerr comes in there and makes his presence known in that Washington goal crease, jostling Mularchuk.
Tim Kerr says he feels terrific. He feels stronger than ever. Goaltender Ron Hextall has been facing some of the shots in practice, says the shot is heavier and harder than ever.
Scratch tonight from the Washington lineup, Gary Galley, Steve Leach, and Ed Kastelic. None of those because of injury. The Flyers are missing Brian Dobbin with Pelle Eklund, Glenn Seabrook out of the lineup, Ron Sutter, J.J. Daigneault, Dave Poulin, Dave Brown, Rick Tocchet, Nick Fetillo, and Bill Root. And of those, only Daigneault and Fetillo are scratched from the game, as well as Seabrook. Everybody else is hurt in one sense or another for the Philadelphia Flyers. Here goes Zezel against Ridley now in the faceoff circle to the left of Mularchuk. Ridley picks the draw cleanly to the boards, and Zezel sends to the side of the net. Now a loose puck right in front, and it's backhanded wide. Kerr got his stick on it, then was dumped to the ice by Larry Murphy. Here's Howe. Miller takes it over to Ridley. A shot and a goal! Mike Ridley from Kelly Miller. And Washington draws a 1-0 lead. They had Ridley open earlier in the game on the other shift on a very similar circumstance. And Mike Ridley finds himself in front to put Washington in front 1-0.
Ridley wastes no time here, but look at three Flyers over to the Capital winger, and nobody goes after Ridley. Gartner and Ridley wide open. Three Flyers go directly at Kelly Miller, leaving the middle of the ice completely wide open. A total breakdown by the Flyers. You mentioned earlier, Mike, the Capitals ran their faceoff play perfectly, where they get the draw back to one of the defensemen. He fires it in the zone and lets Mike Gartner steam down the far wing to get it. Gartner did it, found Ridley, but Ridley, not knowing he had that much time, fired wide early. This time he made no mistakes, and the Capitals jump off with a big early goal.
Here's a centering pass, and Hatcher is able to deflect that wide. And right in the goal mouth, there's some contact between Craig Berube and Clint Mularchuk, as Mularchuk leaned out with his stick and slapped at Berube as he skated back up ice. Now here's Hunter and Berube, and Berube reaches in and shoves his stick right into the ribs of Hunter. We'll see if there's anything called out of this. Kerry Fraser is talking to Berube right now as the linesman Bob Hodges and Ron Finn get in there and separate all those players.
And now Greg Adams and Lou Francis Getty come out on the ice for the Washington Capitals. Two guys who certainly will mix it up physically with the Flyers if that is the style Philadelphia wants to get into.
It's Mike Ridley's 24th goal of the season. Miller gets the assist at the 33-second mark of the first period of play.
Boy, has Mike Ridley been a hot man lately? That gives him 9 goals and 11 assists in the last 20 games.
He'll be our guest tonight at intermission number 2. Here's Greg Smith of Philadelphia out to center ice. Kevin Hatcher dumps it right back inside the Flyers' zone. Now the play is called. We've got an elbowing penalty coming up here, 1:07 into this hockey game, the first penalty call of the game, and it looks like It is Scott Mellenby going off the ice for elbowing. Washington very promptly will have a power play. Now coming back after scoring the game's first goal.
And it gives us time for the first Circuit City power play contest. Tonight's first contestant, Karen Block of Laurel, Maryland. Karen has chosen Dave Christian as the Capitals player to score on the power play. If Christian scores, Karen receives a video or stereo unit courtesy of Circuit City. By the way, if you'd like to enter, just send your name, address, and phone number on a postcard along with the name of the player you think will score in the power play to Circuit City Power Play Contest, Capital Center, Landover, Maryland, 20785.
Well, Dave Christian, a pretty good bet on that power play. 12 power play goals on the season out of his total of 33 on the year. Here's Murphy. Christian's on the ice. Over to Gustafson. Now back to Larry Murphy. A slap shot, a save. A rebound is picked up by Zezel and cleared to the blue line, but not out. Gustafson keeps it in. Back to Larry Murphy at the point. He brings it over to Stevens. Into the corner, and Samuelson clears off the boards, and Stevens dives to keep it in play. Now Mark Howe flips it back to center. Here's Stevens back into his own zone. A minute and a half remaining on the Washington power play. Mellenby is off the ice for elbowing at 1:07 of the first period. Greg Adams, bumped by Samuelson, throws it in, and Hextall picks it up and clears it all the way down. Malarchuk sends it into the corner. Here's Larry Murphy back to take it. Murphy for the Capitals, who lead 1-0 in this game on Mike Ridley's 24th goal of the season. Back out to center. Samuelson dumps it back into the Capitals' end of the rink, and here goes Murphy back to take it again. 55 seconds left to go in the Washington power play. Murphy stick handles up to center ice. Dumps it into the corner. Gartner hustles in on the right wing. Now Adams takes it. Adams back to Larry Murphy. Murphy winds, fires a shot, hit the post. It bounces back to the sideboards, and here's Mike Gartner. Gartner with the puck, cutting in to the side of the net. Can't get it centered. Adams struggles in the corner, brings it back now to Mike Ridley. Ridley out front to Stevens, a shot. Saved by Hextall, a rebound shot. That's blocked by Marsh right in front and recovered by Hextall, and he hangs on.
Good save by Ron Hextall, but Larry Murphy had him beat and rattled it off the post. Capitals 0-24 against the Flyers on the power play coming into this game. This is the Murphy drive that goes off the goalpost. Hextall's got a screen in front of him. That being provided by Mike Gartner, can't see the puck, and the rebound comes caroming off that post, and the Capitals turn it around and get another scoring chance that the big goaltender is able to stop.
Hextall with 6 victories, 2 losses, and a tie in his career against the Capitals, a 1.75 goals against average. Comes into the game at 3.42 on the season against the entire NHL. Here goes the puck to the corner, and Kelly Miller is bumped on the backboards by Mark Howe. Up on the sideboards, Hatcher throws it in behind the net. Mike Gartner tries to dig it free. 10 seconds left on the power play. Langway to Hatcher. His drive blocked, and Hextall manages to find Zezel. He starts to center ice. Here's Murray Craven across the line. Howe tripped up, a drive on goal, and Malarchuk makes the save. Penalty's over. Gartner hooked to the ice. There's going to be a penalty call here against Philadelphia's Peter Zezel. As he hooks Gartner, there'll be another Washington power play. The penalty to Mellenby has just ended. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals 1, the Flyers nothing.
Play opportunity. Watch as Mike Gartner starts up ice. Zezel gets the stick in there. Gartner helps it along a bit and draws the penalty. Well, Karen Block had chosen Dave Christian as a Caps player to score in that first power play. He didn't score, but Karen, you win 4 tickets to a future Capitals home game.
Washington once again with a man advantage, and right away Howe clears it all the way down the ice to ease some of the pressure. Here's Scott Stevens. He's back with Larry Murphy. Prop is into forecheck. Stevens behind the net, wings it up the right side now for Christian. Christian to the center line, dumps it back inside the Philadelphia zone. Hextall picks an opening and clears to the point, but not out. Kept in by Stevens and now cleared out by Craven to center. Here's Prop to the line. Shoves it back into the corner. Larry Murphy goes in to take it. Murphy's pass out to Gustafson. Stick handles up to center ice and finds Pavanka at the blue line. Michael Pavanka puts it in behind the net. Here's Christian trying to work it free. And it's sent all the way down now by Ilkka Sinisalo. A minute remaining in the Washington power play. Zezel off the ice for hooking at 2:16. Mellenby had just returned from serving an elbowing penalty when Zezel was called. Al Hill out for his first shift of the game. He's just up from Hershey, the American Hockey League. Clears it all the way down. Here's Scott Stevens out to Hunter. Now Gartner works to the red line, gets inside Philadelphia ice, a slap shot blocked. Hunter a drive, that goes wide. Hill chases it over to the sideboards and flips it all the way down. Malarchuk passes out quickly to Hatcher. Hatcher gets it ahead now to Mike Gartner. A wrist shot, a save by Hextall. Here's Ridley behind the net. In front, Hunter a drive, that's wide and deflected into the corner. Now Hunter goes in and ties up there, and there's going to be a penalty against Washington. Brad Marsh is spilled into the corner boards, and with 6 seconds remaining in the call to Zezel, Hunter draws the first Washington penalty of this game.
Watch as Brad Marsh heads into the corner. I thought Marsh was going down before Hunter ever got a stick on him, but we'll see it here. Hunter does get the stick in there, but I guess in the manner that Mike Gartner helped along the first hooking call with Peter Zezel, it works out to the Flyers' advantage here as Dale Hunter is into the box for hooking.
Time of the call, 5:10 of period number one.
Capitals lucky to get that Ridley goal because the Flyer penalty killers have kept them off the board. That's the thing you want early when you play the Flyers. A lot of times they come out, try and send a message. That elbowing call, certainly an intimidation foul, but it didn't hurt the Flyers.
1-0 the score. The Capitals with the lead on Mike Ridley's 24th goal of the season. Out of the box comes Zezel, and now Philadelphia has the man advantage. Rookie defenseman Carey Huffman out to Zezel. Up to center ice. Miller gets a stick on it, but Zezel takes it back and fires it ahead to Kerr on the right wing. Langway tries to tie Kerr up in the corner. Jams him to the backboards. Here's Zezel. He's bumped off the play, and the puck goes over to Kelly Miller. Miller and Zezel tie up. Now Sinisalo leans in and tries to stick it free. And it's played up the boards to Sinisalo. Back to Zezel. Zezel in the corner off the skates of the referee, Fraser. And it's cleared all the way down by Kevin Hatcher. 14 minutes to go here in the first period. Another penalty call coming as Greg Smith touches the puck. We've got a minor for tripping, also against Washington. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals 1 and the Flyers nothing.
Month, you can guarantee yourself the best seat in the Capital Center for all home playoff games by putting a deposit on a season ticket or a partial plan for next year. Now, if you'd like more information about those partial plans or season tickets, give Caps office a call at 386-7000. Sales reps are standing by throughout tonight's hockey game.
Scott Stevens penalized for tripping at 6:04 of the first period. Hunter is still in the box for a minute 5 seconds. So right now, Philadelphia has a two-man advantage on the power play. Here's Huffman at the left point. He winds, fires a shot, and a goal. He zings that one right past Malarchuk. And Philadelphia has tied the game. Hunter comes out of the box. Stevens still remains.
And the return of Tim Kerr has immediately paid off dividends. It's Kerr who is right in front of Malarchuk. If he doesn't touch it, he provides a huge screen, and Clint Malarchuk can't see him. Rod Langway trying to move him out, but can't get the job done. And it looks like it just beats Malarchuk cleanly. But that's Tim Kerr up front providing some distraction. And Carey Huffman, who is just making his return to the lineup, since being out with an injury on January 10th, he'd had a Charlie horse that turned into calcium deposits. He hasn't played since January 10th. So the return of Huffman and Kerr are big boosts for the Flyers to tie this game up.
Power play goal for Philadelphia. It's now 1-1. Carey Huffman scoring his third goal of the season. Huber gets an assist, as well as Zezel, at 6:11 of the first period. Zezel and Gustafson collide right in front of the Philadelphia bench. The puck cleared to the corner. Here's Sinisalo in his own zone. Gives it away. Gustafson stealing the puck and firing, but it's blocked. And back come the Flyers again. Here's Sinisalo up to center ice. Over to Kerr. Now across the blue line to Zezel. He works his way in. Can't get the shot off. tries to get help from Kerr, throws it behind the net, and here's Rod Langway tied up by Tim Kerr. Now to Gustafson. He clears it all the way down. There's still 50 seconds remaining on the penalty call to Scott Stevens for tripping. 1-1 the score. 12:40 to play here in the first period. Propp starts out, brings it ahead to Craven. Craven gets across the line. Craven goes into the corner. Tries to flip it in front of the net. Here's Kevin Hatcher to take it. Sends it off the sideboards to the blue line. Kept in by Howe. And Bobby Gould blocks that shot out to center. Mark Howe back to his own line. Leads it over to Crossman. Now to Craven. To Mark Howe. Howe drops it at the point. Mellenby's shot blocked. Here's Howe with it. He centers, and it goes all the way to the point for Crossman. Crossman into the corner. Back to the point again, and this one hops off the stick of Crossman and goes back into the Philadelphia zone. Time runs out on the Scott Stevens penalty. He's back on the ice, and Washington is again at full strength. Here's Propp over to Samuelson. Fires it off the sideboards into the Washington zone. Into the corner goes Mellenby, and here's Larry Murphy to start out. Brings it ahead. Ivan Korovo checked at the center line. Al Hill starts back, brings it ahead to Mellenby. His shot just missing wide of the Washington net. Out comes Derek Smith. Backs it up to Brad Marsh. Looks for Magnus Rupe, and here's Larry Murphy for the Capitals, poking it back to neutral ice. Lead pass gets between the skates of Hunter, and now Marsh sends it across the line. Here comes Samuelson into the Washington zone, a wrist shot. Malarchuk makes the save, and he holds on to stop play with 11:09 remaining here in the first period. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals won, the Flyers.
The Spectrum in Philadelphia, Caps and Flyers tied at 1, 11:09 left in the first period. Shel Samuelson with a shot on, and Dale Hunter gets a little bit of a stare and a stick swing, or a stick poke at him by Samuelson after the shot was saved by Malarchuk.
Here's Ridley throwing it off the backboards now for Michael Pavunka. He flips to center ice, and Marsh takes it there. Dumps it back into Washington territory. Here's Scott Stevens to the corner. He and Mellenby collide. Pavunka's in the corner now, trying to work it loose, and finally brings it out to Mike Ridley. Ridley passes to the point. Gartner is able to grab it there and kicks it out to center. Now the puck thrown back into Washington territory. Here into the corner goes Mellenby. He centers, but Ridley's there to steal. Now Ridley. Out to Pavanka to center ice for Stevens. He's in with Gartner, and Gartner thought there was a pass coming. Tried to straddle the blue line at the last minute, but he was offside on the play.
Everywhere you go, the talk again about the terrific play of Scott Stevens, a true legitimate Norris Trophy candidate. Assists in his past 8 games, 55 assists on the year. That is a new career high for Scott Stevens, eclipsing 51 from last year. And here's another perennial Norris Trophy candidate, a man who's certainly come on after a slow start with 16 goals and 35 assists, Mark Howe.
Zezel works the draw against Gustafson. Back to Hatcher, over to Langway, and now up the right wing for Christian. That's stolen. Here come the Flyers back. Kerr brings it to Propp. Propp cutting to the net, tries to center, and it bounces just wide. Zezel tries to throw it in front of the goal. Rod Langway gets in there and feeds the pass off now to Bengt Gustafson. Gustafson working at his own blue line. Passes to Hatcher. Throws it out to center. It's inside the Philadelphia zone. Greg Adams to the corner. Here's Adams. Has it knocked free. He's bumped to the ice by Zezel on the play. And now Adams dumped rather unceremoniously on a check thrown over in the other corner. And now we have play stopped inside the Philadelphia zone. That hit by Willie Huber on Greg Adams.
Well, this is what Willie Huber was gotten acquired by the Flyers to do. He doesn't throw his weight around that much. He's a big guy. He certainly has got the size. Now, there's a guy who always does throw his weight around, that being Peter Zezel, and then he grabs the puck and moves it ahead for a hand pass. Flyers, though, have come out hitting a little bit now. Certainly have opened up the action quite a bit. Willie Huber, much travel this year. Started with the Rangers, went out to Vancouver, now here in Philadelphia. traded right just a couple weeks ago.
You think it'd be a little easier for Huber to play the physical style of hockey that so many coaches and GMs have wanted him to play? Can he play that a little easier here in Philadelphia?
I would think so. It certainly has got to be contagious. He's got plenty of guys out there doing it with him. I think too many teams have looked at Willie Huber to provide that. The Flyers are just asking Willie Huber to join in with the rest of them. Doesn't have to do it all by himself.
In other words, instead of being the hitman on his own, here he's just part of the gang.
That's right. Put on a leather jacket, wear the colors, you're part of the gang.
Out to center ice, Greg Smith of the Capitals whips it back to the Flyer line, and Howe starts ahead. Drops it off. Here's a shot on goal. Malarchuk makes the save, stopping Berube. And Bob Gould picks it up, brings it to the blue line. It's kicked loose at center ice. Berube works it over now to Mellenby. Here's Mellenby's slap shot. That's blocked by Greg Smith of the Capitals. Dale Hunter starts out now for Washington, up to center ice. Right wing pass. Larry Murphy down the middle for Hunter, and he pokes it wide. The puck drawn back to the sideboards. Berube bumped to the side now by Christian. High stick to the ice by Berube. There's going to be a penalty call here for hooking against Philadelphia's Craig Berube. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals won, the Flyers won.
The Bullets will be on WDCA TV 20 Sunday afternoon right here at the Spectrum, facing Philadelphia in a crucial Atlantic Division game. It's live at 2:30 with Mel Proctor and Phil Chenier giving you all the action. Watch it right here on your superstation for sports, DC 20. 7 in a row for the Washington Bullets, 11 out of 12 for the Washington Capitals. Makes for some happy times for owner Abe Poland.
And well-deserved happy times. Both clubs certainly playing pretty well right now, and the Capitals tonight tied here in Philadelphia 1-1, 9 minutes to go in the first period. Here's Mike Gartner on the right wing up to center ice. Gets it over to Adams. Drops it back now for Kevin Hatcher. He's in across the blue line on the right wing. Hatcher to the corner. Works it back to the point for Mike Ridley. Ridley winds, a slap shot blocked. The puck's loose, and it's covered by Hextall. Adams was trying to dig it free, and Hextall hangs on to make the play. Berube's hooking call comes at 10:59 of the first period.
Capitals kind of get themselves reversed a bit. Hatcher's down low in the spot Ridley normally would take, and there is Mike Ridley up high. He unloads the shot. It's partially blocked by Zezel, but there is the loose puck that Greg Adams is able to take a couple swipes at before Hextall covers with the help of Mark Howe.
Mike Keenan has certainly gone to Hextall a lot this year. Tonight is his 54th game. Mark LaForest, the backup goaltender for Philadelphia in this contest.
Mike, this is going to be a key area as far as I'm concerned in this game. With all the injuries, Spoolin, Sutter is out. Peter Zezel is the only natural center on the main Flyer roster. He's going to spend an awful lot of ice time out here tonight. The Capitals need to take advantage in this area in faceoffs, particularly in the Flyers' zone. It's Ridley against Zezel now, but if Zezel gets tossed out of there or if Zezel gets replaced, you don't have guys with a lot of center ice experience, and the Caps do.
They'll look to Murray Craven here to go against Ridley after Zezel is removed. Greg Adams has the puck to the blue line. It is kept in by Stevens, but then he tries to find Hatcher, and it comes out of the zone. Kevin Hatcher over to Scott Stevens. Stevens works ahead to center ice. Pass into the skates of Adams, and it's stolen by the Flyers and cleared all the way down by Howe. Stevens behind the net over to Kevin Hatcher. 1-1 the score, 8 minutes to play here in the first period. Hatcher to center ice, gets across the blue line. Poke checked. Cleared by Marsh out to center, and Stevens sends it right back in. Delayed offside, and as Ridley touches it, there's the whistle to stop play. Well, the Capitals winning 5 straight and 11 out of their last 12 games. Philadelphia losing 3 straight, and just prior to the 3 straight losses, the Flyers had 6 wins, no losses, and a tie in their previous 7. So Philadelphia with a good streak. And then it's followed by some sadder times for Philadelphia fans, and certainly the injuries, something that they hope will be resolved before playoff time, and they really should. The medical report is not a serious one. But Kerr coming back tonight has given the Flyers a lift here early in the game, although Washington scored the first goal. Mike Ridley, his 24th of the year, followed by Huffman's third of the season for Philadelphia. Again, the Flyers cleared all the way back to Washington ice, and here goes Larry Murphy to pick it up. Murphy stick handles to center, drives it into the corner. Christian goes in on the right wing. Hunter tries to dig it out. Back to the blue line. Winding, a shot by Ledyard right on. The save made by Hextall. Here comes Craven to start out. Up to Propp. Propp gets across the blue line. Hook check. Clear to the sideboards. Into the corner, and it's past Gustafson's stick. Craven picks it up. Now Gustafson steals. He starts back to Dave Christian. Christian at the blue line. Checked on the play. Knocked to the ice. And Philadelphia controls. Here comes Ilkka Sinisalo into the Washington zone. Langway ties him up. Greg Smith of the Capitals goes to the corner. Up to Langway. Off the sideboards and cleared out to center. Huffman shoots it right back in. Delayed offside here as Langway starts out. Right wing pass for Franceschetti. The offside is waved off. The Caps come to center. Here's Miller across the blue line. Kelly Miller tries to get past Crossman. Turns it around. Hauled to the ice. There's going to be a penalty call here against Philadelphia. And now Hextall comes out and takes a run at Peter Sundstrom of the Capitals. There's a break in the action with the score. Washington 1, Philadelphia 1.
No matter what else you do, if your brakes aren't right, there's one precaution it pays to take. Midasize. For just $69 an axle, Midas will fix them right the first time. We won't miss a thing. We'll install new brake shoes or pads, turn drums or rotors, repack front wheel bearings, even front grease seals if needed, and more. Guaranteed. It's a lot for $69, but that's how much we care. Midasize. Get it right the first time.
Caps return home from some big Patrick Division games. It's Saturday night against the Rangers at 7:35. By the way, all fans receive a Caps thermal mug courtesy of a lawn boy. Then on Friday night, March 18th, a real big battle with the New York Islanders. It's their final regular season visit to the Capitol Center, with the Islanders just 1 point behind right now. Certainly could be a big battle for first place. It's an 8:05 faceoff. We understand there are still plenty of good seats available for the Islander game. So call Phone Charge at 432-0200. The penalty is to Doug Crossman at 13:51 for holding.
Puck cleared all the way down again back inside the Washington zone. Capitals coming into the game eighth in the league on the power play at 22%. The Flyers seventh in the league at killing off penalties at 81.6%. Here's a broken stick as the puck goes to the corner. The Capitals' Mike Ridley is without lumber. He skates back to the bench and Murphy takes the puck to his own line. Ridley has a new stick. Here comes Scott Stevens. Over to Murphy. Murphy looks for Gartner, but the puck stolen by Al Hill. Hill with it inside the line. Over to Craven. He flips to center. It comes right to Gartner. A break for the Capitals. Gartner to the blue line. Now here's Miller, a high shot. That's blocked by Hextall. To the point. Scott Stevens ready to take it, but it takes a bounce and gets past him. Murphy inside the zone to Gartner. Over now to Stevens. Stevens way over on the right point. And stick handling takes it outside the line. And as it's touched by Murphy again at the point, the delayed offside is called. There'll be a faceoff with 5:01 remaining here in the first period.
Flyers, of course, such a great penalty-killing team, but they really have given the Capitals difficulty this year. We documented the what is now an 0-for-27 situation in terms of power plays, but they are so aggressive up at the points, and they really force you to make the mistakes. They don't sit back in a box and let you throw the puck around. They charge you. They make you do something, and they are so quick and so smart that a lot of times they create those turnovers. Difficult to go cross ice against them, pass through that box. They are a very disciplined team in that regard. They don't get caught out of position much when they're killing penalties.
Hunter gets the draw, brings it back, and Grant Ledyard sends it over to Kevin Hatcher. Here comes Hatcher to the center line. Gets across the blue line. Inside Philadelphia ice. Brings it to the point for Grant Ledyard. Now over to Hatcher again. Kevin Hatcher's slap shot deflected just wide by Gustafson. And Propp steers it out of the zone all the way back into the Washington Capitals zone. Down to 25 seconds remaining on the penalty call to Doug Crossman for holding. Capitals on the power play, and here's Hatcher across the line. Throws it to the point for Hunter. He brings it over to Ledyard. Ledyard now to Hatcher. Back to Ledyard. To the side of the net for Dave Christian. Christian walks in, shoots, and it's blocked by Hextall. Penalty's over. Crossman's out of the box. Here's Dave Christian with the puck. Keeps the pressure on. Here's a slap shot just wide of the mark. Back to the point for Ledyard. Throws it to Hunter in the corner. Now Al Hill takes over for Philadelphia, and he gives it away to Gustafson. But it's taken back by Propp and cleared all the way down the ice by Marsh. Ledyard back to retrieve it. Icing is the call with 3:45 to play in period one. There's a break in the action with a score. The Capitals won, the Flyers won. 1-1 the story. Mike Ridley's 24th goal of the season got the Capitals started just 33 seconds into this game. And Kerry Huffman connected on a power play goal at the 6:11 mark of the first period. So far, the Capitals have 13 shots on goal. And Philadelphia has only six. Here's Zezel ready to match up against Peter Sundstrom. Linesman Ron Finn ready to drop the puck. The Flyers get the faceoff. Samuelson clears the zone. Langway has it back at center ice. Puts it in behind the net. Mark Howe. Right side pass. Out to center ice, and Howe has it again. Gets it across the blue line. Zezel cuts for the net. Howe takes it in the corner, and now Greg Smith of the Capitals wings it over to the other side. Samuelson ties up there. Works it behind the goal. Back to the sideboards. Propp tries to dig it free. Greg Smith of the Capitals, bumped by Zezel. Now Rod Langway skates behind the goal. Clears it up the boards. Brings it out to Sundstrom. Gets across the blue line. Here's Peter Sundstrom. A slap shot. Hit the post. Sundstrom cranks one right off the post. Into the corner again. Here goes Franceschetti. It's taken back by Philadelphia's Tim Kerr. Inside the Washington zone, Propp throws it behind the goal. Malarchuk leaves it there, and Scott Stevens starts out. Here comes Stevens to center ice. He's in across the blue line, and Korovo came in just ahead of him. The Capitals are offside. Scott Stevens, with points in 11 of the last 12 games, has had 4 goals, 12 assists, and 16 points during the last dozen games. It's been a big part of the Capitals' surge here, in which they have won 11 out of 12. The Capitals with goaltender Clint Malarchuk in goal for most of them. Washington giving up 2 goals against per game. The lone loss out of those dozen games at Los Angeles. The score was 4-3 there. So the Caps averaging 2 goals against per game and are scoring nearly 5 goals per game. 4.92 goals on the offensive side for the Washington Capitals. Certainly a pleasant return to some offense, although the Capitals are based on defense. They're getting the goals when they've needed them, with a lot of offensive contributions as well as stellar defensive play. Here's Malarchuk behind the net, out to Stevens. He gives to Hunter, and it's broken out to center ice. At the line is Korovo. Tosses into the corner. Hustles in past Huffman. Hextall plays it into the corner. It gets away from Hunter, and back come the Flyers. Here comes Sinisalo to center ice. Long drive deflected wide by Malarchuk. The puck centered. Craven tries to get a shot off. And Bobby Gould skates ahead to center ice. A minute 45 to go in the first period. Gould has Huber beaten, but now Huber holds on to him, takes him to the backboards. Hunter tries to center it, and Hextall freezes the puck against the side of the net. Got several games going on out of town tonight, and a couple of results coming in already. Los Angeles is at Boston this evening, and Ken Linsman has scored his 25th goal of the year for the Bruins to give them a 1-0 lead over the LA Kings.
Vancouver is at Detroit. Barry has a goal for Vancouver. Both those scores in the first period. The Canucks leading the Red Wings 1-0. We'll also have results tonight from Quebec playing at New York against the Islanders. Pittsburgh is at St. Louis. And later on, Winnipeg is at Calgary. Right here, it's a 1-1 story with 1:36 to go in period one. Al Hill lines up on the wing for the Flyers, just called up today from the Hershey Bears of the American Hockey League. Hill, Seabrook, Rupe, Dobbin, and Lamoureux all summoned from the Flyers American League Farm Club in the wake of all the injuries that Philadelphia has suffered. Al Hill, in with 10 games, or rather 10 goals, 20 assists, and 30 points, has taken 62 minutes in penalties with the Hershey Bears. Hill has been with the Flyers many years, broke in the Philadelphia organization back in 1976 when they put their players with the Springfield Indians of the American Hockey League. Here's Mark Howe sending it back inside the Washington zone. Here's Rod Langway to the corner, and now Hatcher is in to pick it up. Langway ties up in the corner. The whistle blows. And we have another call of delayed offside, stopping the action here with a minute 10 to go in the first period. You could probably liken the return of Kerr to the Flyer lineup tonight, very similar to the lift that the Capitals got when Rod Langway returned to the Washington lineup following an injury earlier in the season. Both players are leaders on their respective teams. And Langway has been healthy ever since, although still has some pain in his back, has not missed a game. We're in the final minute of play in the first period, and a faceoff will be held now in neutral ice just to the Washington side of center ice. Gustafson is out there at center with Christian on the right wing and Michael Pavanka on the left. Larry Murphy and Scott Stevens are the defense pairing. Tim Kerr comes out for the Flyers with Zezel and Prop, and it's Howe and Samuelson back on the blue line. Flyers get the draw, and here comes Howe. Over to Samuelson, ahead off the stick of Kerr into the corner. Scott Stevens goes to take it. Jams up Pavanka, sending it to the side of the net, trying to clear it behind the goal, and now Gustafson fishes it out and skates ahead to center. Here's Gustafson flipping it across the line, back inside the Philadelphia zone. Pavanka has it behind the net. Michael Pavanka jammed to the corner boards by Samuelson. Zezel in there to try and work it free, and Gustafson hangs onto him. There'll be a faceoff with 30 seconds to play in the first period. Washington has won three of the four games against Philadelphia so far this year. The last outing, a 1-0 overtime win at the Capitol Center back on January 31st. Kelly Miller scoring an overtime goal in that one. Washington also winning by scores of 3-1 and 4-1. So the victories have been affairs in which the Flyers have never scored more than one goal. The lone Philadelphia win was a 3-2 verdict. And there are still some to go. Other meetings between these two clubs before the Patrick Division playoffs get going. Here's Scott Stevens back in his own end now with just 12 seconds to go in the period. Lead pass ahead to Ridley. He's across the line. Passes to Gartner at the point. A slap shot, sticked wide by Hextall. He's dumped right in front of the net. And as time runs out, some pushing and shoving in front of that goal as Hextall comes out and gives Miller a shove. And Hextall is irate. Still leaning in there yelling at Pavanka and gives Carey Fraser, the referee, an earful as he departs the ice. Shots on goal during the first period. Washington with 13 shots on goal and Philadelphia with 6. Our live exclusive coverage continues in a moment after we pause for these messages here on DC 20.